In this video, we will know how to arrange bricks in a wall made in rat trap bond, and also what are the advantages and disadvantages of it. Rat trap bond is a brick masonry method of wall construction, just like English bond and Flemish bond, but having a different set of rules and regulations for laying the bricks. In rat trap bond, the bricks are placed in vertical position, while as we saw in English bond and Flemish bond or other bonds, the bricks are laid horizontally. Which means, if the size of the brick is 230 mm by 115 mm by 75 mm, then the 75 by 230 mm surface of the brick will be acting as a base for the brick in the rat trap bond, which is different from other bonds in which 115 by 230 mm surface of the brick act as a base for the brick to be laid in a course. Due to the vertical positioning of the brick, cavity is created within the wall of one brick thickness. It is named as rat trap as it creates complex network of bricks inside the wall, which creates a space in which rats can be trapped easily. The arrangement of the bricks in rat trap bond is similar to double Flemish bond in one brick thickness. You can see the arrangement of bricks in both double Flemish bond and rat trap bond simultaneously. The first two stretchers in double Flemish bond is laid on 115 by 230 mm surface. And on the rat trap bond, same bricks are laid on the 75 by 230 mm surface. Because of this, the height of wall increases automatically in every course, and ultimately decreasing the number of bricks used in the same surface of wall with any other bond. Also, due to the hollow surface in between, the area used for cement is also reduced. And due to the cavity inside, it gives good thermal comfort inside the building. But it should only be done by the masons who are trained in rat trap bond. Otherwise, there will be wastage of mortar falling into the gap while working. We cannot use concealed wiring or plumbing due to the complex brick network inside. If we break any one brick, many other bricks will fall down or crack, which will reduce the strength of the wall. Now let's see how we will join two rat trap bond walls in 90 degrees. At the junction, we start with placing two stretchers together. After that, we follow the same rat trap bond pattern as we did before. This creates our course 1. In course 2, we start with placing two headers at the corner. And after that, we can continue the same rat trap bond pattern. Now let's put the courses one above another of the wall and see the overall appearance of the wall. So guys, this was all about rat trap bond. Join me on Facebook or other social platforms to get connected and talk on it. If any doubt or questions, write them down in the comment section. And also don't forget to like, subscribe and share my videos to your friends in need. Thanks.